What advice? I think the biggest thing of advice is just never give up. Don't quit. Keep pushing, because it does get better the further you go.
The warrior trial primary is an opportunity for us as the command to go out and to select or identify those athletes that will compose the Army team, which for this year, it will be composed of 40 athletes from various sports. Through that, we'll actually go in and categorize them based on their injuries or their new normals. The WTC is actually here to develop, coordinate, and integrate the Army's Warrior Care and Transition Program for all wounded, ill, and injured soldiers, as well as veterans.
I think sport and competition are absolutely imperative in the recovery process. You know, I believe that recovery needs to encompass the mind, the body, and the spirit, and sport and competition are part of that triangle.
Warrior Trials is beneficial to athletes because for people that are competitive and need to express that in some sort of games, it's awesome to have, you know, a group setting where you can compete. And for disabled athletes, I think it's even more so important because it just helps with the bonding.
I actually grew up shooting archery. When I got injured in Afghanistan, I didn't think I'd be able to ever again. And then the OT department at Fort Riley was like, why don't you just give it a shot? We have archery here. So I just gave it a shot and fell in love with it again. And then it just took off from there.
There's always a purpose to archery, not just for shooting, but for healing. And that there's other boundaries you can go outside of it. I definitely suggest archery as part of a recovery help, mainly because we get to focus on things other than what else is going on. Archery really lets you sit down and focus on one thing, one small activity, just aiming, and in that little moment, they'll get lost, and you'll blank out and forget everything around them.
Archery is something I just started, but I've actually grown to love it a lot. It's kind of like a relaxation thing. It's just me, the bow, and the arrows. I can take my time setting up. It's not something you gotta go quick. And I've learned to actually let things go sometimes rather than hold on to them.
This event's really great because there are cyclists of all levels, from just beginning cyclists to people who have been riding for many, many years. And so, you know, some of the best parts of this are getting people, you know, really fine-tuned on their bike, you know, people that may not have had a lot of experience so far, getting them comfortable and riding, that's been great.
The second that guy drifts to the left, don't try and sprint forward. Just keep running the same pace, you'll get in front of them, and that's what keeps it nice and tight and smooth. All right?
I love working with other branches of service. It always kind of brings a different mixture rather than working with what you normally have. Even though we kind of butt heads it sometimes, everybody has like their jokes, but I like it. Seeing different faces, you know, you get to talk to each other, interact, and then you get to find out like what they do and what they've been through.
I think joint competition is awesome. It allows us to see our brothers and sister units. You don't get to see that a lot. You know, like in my military career, very seldom did I train with the other services. And here we are, we're competing in different sports.
Coming into the Warrior Transition Battalion and hearing about a swim program and then hearing about the Warrior Games, just an amazing opportunity for me to get back to something I really loved.
Swimming, I've been swimming as long as I can remember. It was always a favorite, me and my dad. Like, I'd either get on my dad's back, and like, he would take me underwater, and we would just, he'd make me hold my breath until he came back up for the top half. So it's kind of brings about like a lot of like fond memories, me and my dad.
This is more of a mental sport, shooting is. And you have to be very clear-headed. You can't be worried about something else, otherwise that whatever you're worried about comes out in your shooting, comes out in each and every shot. So you kind of have to find a routine that helps you reset your mind each time you take a shot.
Coaches are outstanding. They helped me a great deal in the short space of time that I've been here. So I owe them a lot of credit for my 10s that I'll be shooting.
What I really want to achieve is to get to that next level. You know, I want to get to the next level of the sport that I'm in.
The competition drives us to do more, work harder, and as overall, it helps us in the recovery process. You know, you get stronger, you get faster, you start to forget about things that's going on, the PTSD and stuff like that. For that moment, you're forgetting about all the problems, all the injuries you have. You're just competing against your brothers or your fellow soldiers or Marines or Air Force guys, airmen or sailors. So, and we have fun with it. You know?
For me, what I've noticed is the fact that they're willing to learn, and they're willing to be as best as they can be at it. Before practice, after practice, they're constantly coming up and asking questions, and just, you know, they're almost like a sponge. And you just feed them with so much information, they're just gradually gathering it and just want to be better, and it's amazing.
All right, after you guys throw it, I'll say mark. You guys have control. We're walking.
The athletes actually did very well. For only having four practices, you know, they've really come a long way. And as we could see today, you know, they're really excited to see themselves improve in a short amount of time. And they've kind of gotten hungry and want to keep doing it, which is a great thing.
Everybody's trying to help everybody, everyone's cheering everybody on, and just seeing everyone overcome whatever physical disabilities they may have to come here and to compete, it's great to see.
Everything's been awesome. Camaraderie, the competitiveness, the friendships, the coaching, the mental coaches, everything. So right before I threw, one of the gates started closing in on me, and one of the mental coaches actually said to just find your reset. So I just kind of reset and went at it, and just having fun out here.
There you go, Mike.
What I want to see across the board as a whole is it seems like we're such a small community, and we just need to stick by each other and help each other out, show each other the way and how to cope, and you know, just help each other out.
You can't move forward if you're looking in the past. You know, accept your injury, own it, and move forward. Because life is going to keep moving. The world keeps turning. If you decide to stand still, you're going to get passed by. So, and a lot of people don't realize, like, my injury and everybody else's injury, when you're out here doing these type of things, it inspires others, not just military, but it inspires other people that don't have any injuries. People look at you and be like, oh, well, if this guy can do it, then I know I can do it. At the end of the day, that's what it's all about.
Since the first day, I've seen a lot of athletes who are just opened up to the possibility that they can get something big out of what all of the coaching staff has to offer.
This adaptive sports program is really awesome. It's really helped a lot. It's really it's a privilege to be out here with fellow Army athletes and athletes from your other forces.
The big thing I look at is everybody's performance. I've seen some times that people didn't expect to get. So I think that's what's great, the camaraderie. You know, me, I'm just one person, but all of us together just coming into it for the common goal, to do better than we did last week, is that's the important thing.
These events, they give you hope. I mean, when you have an injury happen, you know, you get the despair of well, you know, I can't go back to the life I had. But these events show you that there's a life out there besides the pain. You can continue on, and you can. There's so much more. I mean, the hill might be steep, but it's worth it. These guys, you know, are here to push you and help you and inspire you to be better.
These athletes are just absolutely awesome. There's a lot of fight still there. They don't really see things as challenges. And it's just a matter of going out there and treating them like you would treat any other athlete. So I don't really accept challenge. Like, you just go out and do what you do.
I failed, but I got back up. My injury doesn't define who I am. My amputation doesn't define who I am as a person. I make who I am.
You know, even though, you know, I've been through a horrific incident or horrific injury, it doesn't end. You know, life continues, and this is just a great forum to get after it.
Thank you. He does not approve chest bumps.
You can get through it. That's what I really have to say. You can get through it, and if you don't think you can do it by yourself, there is help.
If you don't have fun with things and you sit there and you stress about them, like, they'll get worse. So if you have fun with it, you enjoy it. Regardless if you win or if you lose, you're still having fun with it.
I'm hoping that, you know, I can learn enough here that I can influence my team and bring them up with me. That's what I want. I want to inspire others and be inspired.